We are about to deep dive into some drugstore favorites of 2020, the very best that caught my attention and kept it this year. Let's get into that video right now. Hi, my friends. So much fun to be making this video for you. I have a lot of products here that are from the drugstore that I wanted to share. And I will start off with really good intentions of going from how they apply to my face or what order they go in my face. But lots of times I get distracted and I don't do it all exactly in order. So please forgive me. If you're new here to my channel, I would love to have you as a subscriber. So hit that button below, the red button below. And don't forget to hit the bell icon if it does any good or not. We don't know because so many people aren't getting notified that videos are going up that do have the bell rung. And everybody, if you wouldn't mind, please give this video a thumbs up. It does help me so much. And you guys know, if you've been with me for any length of time, that you make my channel so much fun and you make my channel worth doing. And so I want to tell you thank you for every minute that you watch my video. I do thank you. I want to get into these drugstore yummy products right now. So let's start out with something that I don't have, and that's primers. I have the e.l.f. Putty Primer, and honestly, it really is my favorite at the drugstore. Nothing has replaced it. It's one that I love. And I didn't put it in here because I've talked about it for so many years. Let's go on to something that I haven't talked about for years that came to me in 2020. Now, I think there's a few things in here that weren't released in 2020, a lot of them, but they were new to me. So that's what I'm looking at. So number 7 has these two foundations. Actually, I fell in love with almost every foundation that number 7 has. And this one is the Lift and Luminate Triple Action Serum Foundation with an SPF of 15 in it. This gives a beautiful satin finish. It is what I'm wearing today. It is my favorite foundation at the drugstore. It's not too heavy on my mature skin. It doesn't show up texture and my pores, and yet my dry skin loves it because it's not super matte. It's like a demi matte or a satin, and I really like it. Nice delivery system with a bottle and a pump on it. And yeah, I have mine in Cool Ivory. And then also from number 7 that I have in Cool Ivory is their Protect and Perfect Advanced All-in-One Foundation. This is a straight-on dupe for the It Cosmetics CC cream that they've done forever, and they did a great job with the dupe. I almost think that I like this one a little bit more because it's a little bit thinner and it doesn't show any texture. Whereas the CC cream, if I'm not careful and you get too much on at once, the coat can be too thick. And so I think I like this one so much better. It's just really good. So this is in a squeezy tube, which is fine as well, because I feel like you can always get all of it out if you need to. And then at the very end, you can cut it and get every little drop out if you want to. But this has been a great foundation for me, and it's really good on dry skin as well. Now, if you are one of my gals that has combo or oily skin, they do have another one that I will throw up on the screen because I can't remember what it's called. That's really good as well. And a lot of people have told me that it's really good for their skin that is oily. And so these are because I'm dry, but man, I am in love with both of these so much. Now, along with foundations, I did have the LA Girl Pro Color Foundation Mixing Pigment last year in my favorites, but I'm putting it in this year as well because I feel like these are workhorse products. This bottle is half empty because this bottle will save every single foundation I have. I have a very cool undertone. And when I buy a foundation that's way too warm, orange, yellow, anything too peach, this will counteract that with a very small amount, mix it up, and I've got my foundation and it's completely saved. And the same thing with this, only if your foundation's too dark. Now, what's really great about these is even though these are matte, they don't mess with the foundation's formula or what the foundation's consistency is because you use such a small amount. So I love these. I think they're great. Again, a glass bottle with a pump on them. And yeah, both of these are wonderful. I really believe that everybody should have these in their makeup kit because it saves you so much money on foundations. Now, as far as powder goes, I absolutely love, fell in love with the number 7 Lift and Luminate powder. And this is a dupe for the Charlotte Tilbury Airless Powder Airbrush. Let's not say airless. airbrush powder. And I actually have that one. I think this is a little bit creamier. I like this one a little bit more. Jessica Braun is the original one that said that this was like that. She was right. It's really, really good. It's nice. It's a soft powder. I can blur out my makeup with it, and I just love it. I think it's one of those ones that anybody can use, anybody can wear. It does have just a little bit of a brightening property to it, not a luminous property to it where it's going to show a glow. It's just really brightening, and I think it's so pretty. Now, the other powder that I have that I found this year is from Sydney Grace. This is an exact dupe for the Hourglass Veil Powder, and I will put that video below as well where I compared all kinds of powders and got the dupes for them. And this powder comes in like four different colors, I think. Comes in fair, light, medium, and deep. I believe this is the fair one, which in actuality is just translucent. It's got a white cast to it. Not anything that's going to show up. And because it's made with mica, it does have a brightening effect to it. And I think that's what's so gorgeous about it. And I love that she gave you a ton more in here. You get way more than you do in the Hourglass. And I love that it's very, very cost effective, and I won't have to purchase the Hourglass ever again if I don't want to. So I think this is a great product for any of us, and hopefully it will be in stock, because I know that there were a couple of colors that have not been in stock all that often. So get on their email list if it's not, and yeah, I think you'll really love this one. As far as setting spray goes, this is from Bella Jade, and this is the makeup setting spray. And the reason that I love this is, number one, it's a pretty good size bottle. Number two, there is absolutely no alcohol in here. So if you are a dry gal and that alcohol spray like All Nighter from Urban Decay or Skindinavia, where it just makes you feel like you're dried out after you put it on, this is a good one for you, for your mature skin. And I really love it. I think that it just refreshes my makeup through the day. It doesn't make me feel sticky. It really just dries down beautifully. The spray is a little bit heavier than I would like, but if you hold it up and you just let the mist drop onto your face, you're not gonna get droplets from it at all. And I love it because of that non-alcohol. It's very refreshing during the day if you wanna refresh your makeup, but it does seem to help the longevity of my makeup as well. And then the other one that I found that I love this year is from L'Oreal. This is the Lumi Shake and Glow Dewy Mist. And it does have a little bit of some sort of an oil in there. I can see that. So you have to really shake this up good. And then, you know, you put it on and it just gives a very, very soft focus to your face. And I think it's a great product for somebody that has dry, mature skin. And I use it all the time. It's so pretty. So if you want just a pick-me-up on your makeup, but you don't want to have to put a bunch of highlighter on, you might really like this. It's really pretty. I have two concealers as well that I love this year. The first one is the Makeup Revolution. This is the Infinite Concealer. And this one is so good about taking care of any of those dark circles underneath your eyes. And I just think it's wonderful as far as being able to have full coverage without being too cakey. Now, I will tell you, and this is a little tip that I talk about all the time, just dot that around, kind of spread it around a little bit, but don't completely blend it out. Let it sit there for a second. And then after you've done something else, like maybe your blush or whatever, go back in and then just either bounce your finger across it, or a beauty sponge. And it's going to give you so much better coverage with less product. So try it. Just use the tiniest amount, and then, you know, dot it across, move it around just a little bit without blending it in completely, and then go back in a minute or two after it's set, and you should have a gorgeous look after you're done blending out. All right, that was a lovely little jaunt. The power went out, and yeah, so I don't remember exactly where I am, but I think I'm at talking about my second concealer that I have on the drugstore list, and that is from number 7. It again is the Lift and Luminate Serum Concealer. This was originally introduced as a concealer for, you know, spot treatments on your face. But I love using this underneath my eyes because it's light. And if you use that method that I just talked about, it does a really good job of concealing, especially if you use a color corrector. And so yeah, this was my number 2 this year. Next up is Contour / Bronzer. I fell in love with this Essence contouring palette. I will say that this is not a perfect contour color because it does have a little bit of warmth in it. So I use this for my bronzer, and what I do is I just take my brush and run it between these two because I'm a lot more fair than that for a bronzer. And this one is, it says it's for fair skin. So the consistency on these is so nice. I mean, it's a beautiful powder. You can see that that is not going to be too orange on you. It's going to be one that is a little bit of warmth without being overly orange or yellow or anything like that. I did a video very recently where I talked about bronzers and how important it is to get a bronzer that isn't too orange when you're cool toned. So these are beautiful mixed together. They do have one that is a little bit deeper. So this is one that I really recommend, and I've been using it ever since I got it. But the one that I reached for the most this year is from L'Oreal. This is the True Match Lumi Bronze It. This was in a video very recently as well. I'm almost to pan on it, and when I swatch it right here, you're gonna see that it is a lot more warm than that one from Essence. And I like that because it does give a little bit of warmth without going too orange. And it's just really pretty. It's soft. It has a tiny bit of a satin finish to it. So it has a little bit of a luminosity without having any texture or anything like that. And yeah, my lid fell off, but I've had this for a while. I really like this. And it's a big, huge pan. You're going to have a hard time getting through it. It blends like a dream. Actually, both of them blend like a dream. And yeah, that's one that I really loved. And then moving on to blushes, the L'Oreal Age Perfect Blush, the Radiant Satin Blush, and this is called Mauved. And I love this color, first of all. I think it's a great color. I love L'Oreal's packaging. I've since lost that little brush that goes in there, but it has a little mirror that you can slip into your purse. But this is a really pretty soft flush. It's not one that's going to show up really bright. It isn't, you know, one that's super duper pigmented. I like that quality in a blush because then, because I am so fair toned, I don't get too much on at once. I don't quite feel that this is a satin. I really feel that this is closer to matte because I don't see any luminosity in it at all. But it wears really good, it blends really good, and goes great on my skin. So the other one that I love this year is from Color Girl. This is the True Blend So Flushed Blush, or So Blushed, whatever it says there. And this one is in Love Me. And this one does have that sheen in it, or that little bit of satiny look to it. I love this, the way the consistency is on this. I think it's so great. This is a very pink color. I love the color of it. It's great for me. It's a brighter color. It's really pretty in the summertime, although it gives a beautiful flush. It's what I'm wearing today. Let me just put a teeny tiny more bit of it on so you can see how pretty it is. It just really goes across the skin nicely. It's very pigmented, so a little bit goes a long ways, but yeah, it's just beautiful. I think it's one of those blushes that I will pick up other colors in, and I'm excited to have it. As far as drugstore highlighters go, I actually have three, and I have the extra one because it is from Sydney Grace. I'll just show that to you first. So Sydney Grace has these gorgeous loose highlighters, and my goodness, they are some sort of special. First of all, the powder is so finely milled, and it's just absolutely a beautiful powder on mature skin. Look at it. Oh my goodness. So this one is, let's see, this one is in Pink Lightning. So it has a little bit of a pink cast to it. Put it under my blush to begin with. And it just has a super beautiful cast underneath there. Instead of looking like you have that highlight on, you're looking more like you just have a flush or a glow underneath your skin or to your skin. When I do my blush and my highlight like this, I get a lot of compliments about people just say, "You're glowing." And it's really nice because, you know, as you age, our skin can get a little bit more sallow. It can get a little bit more dull looking. So it's nice to have that little bit of light underneath your blush. This is a beautiful one that doesn't show texture on me, and it does not have any sparkle in it at all. And as a matter of fact, all of these other two that I'm showing you will not have any sparkle either. Now, another one that is along the lines of that High Beam is the Tribe Highlighter. This is Volume 3. This is by Juvia's Place. And again, it has that quality of woo, baby. It is really something as far as the way that it high beams. It's just wow. It's actually a little bit more than the Sydney Grace. Maybe I just got more. But anyway, it is a beautiful silky highlighter. It can be worn really lightly, but it's going to be more along the lines of that really bright high beam look. That's why I like to wear them underneath my blush, because it diffuses it a little bit. So I think it's so pretty. And then the third one is from Milani. These are their baked highlighters, and this one is in Dolce Perla. And if you are somebody that really, just about lost my stuff. If you're somebody that really enjoyed the Essence Pure Nude highlighter, I think you might really enjoy this one. And it's got that same feel to it, but it's not that intense high beam to it. It's kind of just like brightness. So you can see the difference between these two right here, these three. This one right here is the Milani. So you're looking at just lightening your skin up instead of it being bright. Okay, for eyeliner on my top lash line to tight line across there, I've been loving the e.l.f. This is the H2O Proof Eyeliner Pen. This is a great pen for giving a tiny little line. And it's just gorgeous as far as how black it is, how saturated it is, and look how thin that line is. You can get it really super thin so it can go really tightly on there, and I use black a lot to make sure that I can get a little bit more of a luminous look to my lashes if I really tight line that well. And then the other one is from ColourPop, and this one is a pen liquid liner as well. However, this one is in a cobalt blue color. I think it's crazy something. I'm not sure, but I will make this a little bit bigger so you can see. This is what I have on today. And if you can see the blue cast on that, I love doing that when I'm wearing just a little bit of blue underneath my eyes, or even when I wear a really light blue on my eyelid. I love wearing this because it just seems to give that little bit of dimension to it. And I'm wearing that today. I like both of them. I think that the e.l.f. lasts a little bit longer, but it doesn't come in colors. It just comes in this black for now. But I like them both for different reasons. The e.l.f. one is matte, if you need to know that. It is matte. And as I'm looking at the one from ColourPop right here, it is looking like it's a little bit satin. Just so you know, both of those two. It could be because it's on top of a bunch of highlighter. Why didn't I think about that? I don't know. Anyway, the next thing that I have is from CoverGirl. This is their Exhibitionist eyeliners, and this one is in emerald green. And very recently, I put this in a video as well. I didn't want to put one thing in here that I hadn't shown you guys before. This is a color emerald. This is a gel liner. It's not a mechanical pencil, so you do have to sharpen it with a sharpener. But I love this. I love the consistency. It is absolutely no tug whatsoever. And then if you smudge it out, and you know, if you want to put a little bit of the same color of eyeshadow on top of it, you're gonna have something that's bulletproof, along with same thing with Milani. This is what I'm wearing today. This is the Stay Put eyeliner, and I believe this one is in cobalt. But I love these because they're so creamy to begin with, and then, you know, they dry down to this smudge proof, not waterproof. I won't say that these are waterproof, but smudge proof. And so if you're somebody that has watery eyes, I do right out here a little bit of watery eye, and I will just go ahead and I'll put that down, smudge it out, and then I'll put a little bit of the same color eyeshadow on top of it, and then I will go right underneath it with a very precise brush and use a tiny bit of translucent powder just right underneath it to set it. Then it's going to be budge proof all day, and you're going to love it. So I like these because I love the colors, and I really like the formula on both of them. They're very similar, but you get different colors in them, and I know that they're at different price points. So love both of those. For brows, I only have one product, and it is the e.l.f. Wow Brow. I love this stuff. I love this teeny tiny little spoolie that it has on there, the wand that it has on there. It catches all of my hairs. As I've started into menopause, everything's become weird and jagged, but I do have a few little hairs there, so I like that this catches them. And it also has, I don't think that you can see it, but it also has a little bit of fibers on there that it will deposit to make your hairs a little bit more voluminous, for lack of a better word, for an actual eyebrow. But yeah, I do really love it. It doesn't really set your brows. It's more of like a pomade product that's going to just go into it and kind of form them. So you might want to go in with something else. I use another one. I use Anastasia Beverly Hills. I like this one, and I've been using it all year long, and I'm ready to buy a new tube. To top all the eye stuff off are these great mascaras that I absolutely love, and they came into my life this year. Maybelline's Falsies Lash Lift. And I use the waterproof one. This is the Hourglass wand that everybody kind of goes gaga for right now. Not quite super hourglass, just a tiny bit. It gives you a lot of length, a lot of volume, and it does help hold a curl because it is that waterproof. Now I will say it takes a tiny bit of work to get this one off. It's not like the old ones where we like had to wear it for a week just until it wore off. Remember Maybelline had theirs, and CoverGirl had theirs, that once we put those on there was no way that those were going to budge for the whole week. So it is a little bit harder to come off, but I still love it because of that length and what it does for my eyelashes. And then this one from Essence, the Lash Princess waterproof one, came out this year, and this just has like the pine tree or the Christmas tree regular brush, but I love it because I was a huge fan of the green tube, and this is basically a green tube but waterproof, and it is great. And this one isn't hard to get off, but you will have it on all day, which is what I like about it. And so many mascaras will flake on me that I love having this one. So yay for Essence for coming out with that one. All right, lastly is lips, and I got two lip liners that I'm absolutely in love with. This one is from Essence, and this is called Sucker for Grace. It's their contouring lip liner. It is a very mauve-y color, and this is a little bit more of a stiff formula, and I like it. I like it a lot, and I like it because it stays, and I also like that because it is that little bit of a muted color that I can really just line right below my lip line and get my lips to look a lot more voluminous with this, because it's not going to be a stark color that's going to draw attention to that. So I love this. It's what I picked up almost every day this year. But the other one that was actually sent to me as a gift from Palladio, by the way, this one is one that you have to sharpen. And then this one is the automatic or the mechanical one. I love this color, and I have this on today as my lip liner, and it's just the most beautiful plum color. Let me see if I can, yeah, it's plum. Anyway, it's just a gorgeous plum color. It's got that mauve look to it. Not a lot of red, so it's really leaning towards the rose color, and I think it's so, so pretty. This one doesn't last as long as the Essence one does, but I love this one and how creamy and how easy it is to blend in with other lip glosses and lipsticks that I'm wearing. So like both of those so much. And then I don't have a bullet lipstick in here at all. And that is really weird for me because normally I put some in there, but I wasn't buying a lot of bullet lipsticks this year because we're wearing masks, but I still love my lip products. They are important to me. And I discovered the Sydney Grace lip glosses, but they're not a lip gloss. It's more like a lip color with a high shine to it. I got to get my spectacles and find out what this one is. This first one is Chloe and the other one is Haley. So Chloe is the nude color one. It's a really pretty nude. I do have that in the middle of that Palladio liner. It's a really pretty color nude as far as being just the perfect in between pink and peach. So it's not too peach, it's not too pink, it's just right there, sits in the middle. Did you notice the opacity on that? Look how great that is. I love it when you get a gloss that acts like a lipstick because it has so much pigment to it. And then this Haley one is that muted, really pretty mauve-y color. And this is, whoa, that's my jam, big time. I love Haley. It's just one of those ones that, yeah, I fell in love with. What's beautiful about these is that the formula of it is so much like a gloss. It hugs your lips. You have it on a lot longer than you would a gloss. It's not going to last through eating or anything like that, but it's going to last if you're just talking and visiting with somebody. It's going to last a really long time. And I can't wait to get more of these because this is just a very special gloss. And then to round it all off, we're going to talk about gloss. I found the Maybelline Lifter Glosses. This is such a great formula, and I will say that it has a vanilla coconutty fragrance to it. Kind of, I refer to it as pina colada. That's really what it smells like to me. But this is a gloss that is so pillowy. I don't know how else to describe it. It feels just really lush on your lips, and it gives the prettiest pout to your lips. This one doesn't have any color to it. It's just a clear one, but I love what it does for the lips. It does have a little bit of taste to it, a sweet taste to it. And the other thing is that it lasts a long time. I don't know what that texture is, but it's not one of those ones that gets the yuckies, you know, in your lips right there where that gets the stringy things. I talked about this in another video. That's one of my pet peeves. Or if it has glitter in it that you can feel the particles, that's another pet peeve for lip gloss. Anyway, nothing like that on here. Lasts a long time, feels great on the lips. I want to try other colors of this. I think that most of the colors are going to be sheer. They're not going to be opaque like the Sydney Grace one, but I really like this. And then Juvia's Place came out with lips this year, and I was so happy to see that, with them branching out into complexion products and then into lip products. And I fell in love with their lip glosses. And this one has just a bit of a holographic shift to it. So it's got a lot of dimension to it. And it's got pink and peach that it shifts between, and a little bit of lavender there. And this one, again, it feels really good on the lips. It's hydrating. It doesn't wear off quickly. It just is one that's really a nice gloss that's going to last. But again, I just want to tell you that nothing lasts all day when it's a gloss. If you had a matte lip on, it might last all day, but glosses don't. And I just want to make sure I tell you that. But this is a pretty, pretty color. They do have some of these that are just the sheer colors instead of ones that have the little bit of a sheen in them or a little bit of sparkle in them. There's no grit in this. There's no little particles, anything like that. It's just a beautiful gloss. That is it. That is the best of the best for 2020 from the drugstore. I hope that you did enjoy this. Thanks so much for sticking with me today. I will have a video coming up that will show most of these things in demonstration mode, because it's a get ready with me that I did just do this whole entire look with. So if you're interested in that, I will show that in another video that will be coming up next. And we're going to chat a lot about my health and my channel and different things. And I hope that you will enjoy that one. So stay tuned for that one. I love you guys very much. Please take care of yourselves. Stay happy, stay healthy, stay sanitized, stay safe. Thank you for being with me today, and I will catch you all in my next video. Love you. Bye-bye. As an afterthought, I just wanted to make sure that you knew that I did get this Clarins blush from Octolie that was gifted to me from Clarins through them. And I do like the blush very much. It's a soft blush. However, I feel like it is a little bit too expensive for what you get. And it kind of got a little bit patchy and didn't wear well through the day. But it is a soft blush, and I will continue to try it. But I wanted to make sure that I got this review up. And thank you all for watching it.